Student, I am Swati Kulkarni. I am here to teach you computer for 7th standard. So let's begin with your first chapter, that is software and its types. Software and its type. These are the content of your chapter. First we will learn what is system software, what is application software, what are the graphics, multimedia and presentation software. So in the previous year already you have studied what is computer. What is computer? Computer is an electronic device which accepts the data and instruction as an input. It processes it in the CPU and gives a desired output on the screen. So, computer is an electronic device which it accepts the data and instruction, processes it and gives a desired output. So, we consider one example. We want sum of two numbers. We want sum of two numbers, that is 2 plus 3. We want sum. We want to calculate sum of two numbers. What the computer will do? What the instruction we are giving here? We want sum. We want to calculate sum. The instruction is sum. Sum of two numbers. Two number it can be anything. So we are telling is 2 and 3. So what the data we are giving is 2 and 3. We are giving the input as to calculate the sum of two numbers. Here we are giving the input as to calculate sum of two numbers. Next what the computer will do? It will processes it. Processes means it calculates. Calculate the sum, that is 2 plus 3 is equals to 5. 2 plus 3 is equals to 5. That 5 is stored in the memory. The next is, it will give the output, it will give the desired output on the output screen. That 5 is printed on the output screen. So basically, what is a computer? Computer is an electronic device which accepts the data and instruction, processes it, gives a desired output. Computer is a machine, it will not work on its own intelligence. Always it will work whatever we want, whatever we will feel, it will work like that only. Computer without the instruction is like car without a driver. So computer need instruction. As we now know that the computer works on instruction. So again going back to the same example, that is we want to calculate sum of two numbers. So what the computer instruction will follow? See here, first it will display the sentence on the output screen as print enter two numbers. Print means it will display the sentence on the output screen as enter two numbers. After that it will accept the value in a A. We want to calculate the sum of two numbers, that is 2 plus 3 we want to calculate. So this is A and this is B. So it will accept the value. We are inputting. We are giving the input as 2 as a A. So it will accept the value A. So it will accept the value in a B. B we are giving as 3. It will accept as 3. Next, it will add both A and B store in the sum. It will add both. A value is 2, B value is 3. It will add 2 plus 3 is equals to 5. That 5 is stored in the sum value. It will display, print means it will display the sum value on the output screen. That is 5 is displayed on the output screen. So, these are the instructions to carry out the calculate sum of two numbers. So such type of instruction, such type of set of instruction are called program.
Machine.
Program. So we can take the one more example as if you want to multiply two numbers. Multiply two numbers. So even the computer also follows set of instructions. Same like enter two numbers, it will accept the value A. It will accept the value in B, but here it will multiply. It will multiply A and A and store in the mul value. We can take it as a mul. instruction to carry out the multiplication of two numbers. So the set of instruction are called program. So now the next is, what is software? Software is a collection of programs that tell the computer to perform operations like input, processing and output. So brain, how it will give the instruction to react our body. Similarly, software will give the instruction to computer to perform operation like input, processing and output. One good example is calculator. So calculator will do the multiple operations. It is what like addition, subtraction, multiplication. So it is a collection of program. So we call it as software. Software is of two types. One is system software and another is application software. So the next is, what is system software? So the system software is a collection of a program that controls the overall operations and internal working of the computer system. So the overall operations means it reads the data from the input device, it processes it, it stores in the memory, it gives the output. So the system software is a collection of a program that controls the overall operations and internal working of the computer system. It reads the data from the input device, it transfers the information into the output device. So the one good example for system software is operating system, which with the operating system, without the operating system, computer will not work. So now there are two type of system software. One is operating system and another is utility programs. So now let's understand, what is operating system? Now what is operating system? Operating system that controls overall activity of the computer. It acts link between user and the hardware. So it acts as a link. Acts as a link between user and the hardware. So user means what? Those who are working on the computer. It acts as a link between user and the hardware. Hardware means computer. It works like a link between user and the hardware. These are some examples for operating system, like Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 8, Unix and Linux. So what is operating system? Operating system controls the overall activity of the computer. So now we will learn, what are the functions of operating system? First one is device management, that is input and output. It controls the working of all the input and output devices. Input device means the keyboard, mouse, etc. And the output devices such as printer, monitor and so on. It controls the working of all the input and output devices. The second one is memory management. Memory management will assign the memory to the various programs, like whenever it is required. It frees when it is not required. Next feature is runs the software. It will run the various software like a Paint, MS Word, MS PowerPoint. So the next feature is processor management. It manages the working of processor by allocating the various job. Allocating the various job means it will assign, it will give the various job. So the next feature is file management. It keeps the track of information regarding creation, deletion, transfer and storage. You all will create folders, right? You can create the folder, delete, transfer from one location to another location, and you can store also. You can copy the file from computer to pen drive or a CD. Is it right? So the feature is file management. So the last one is security. It provides the security by giving the password. You, by logging to your operating system, you will give the password, right? So this is also one of the feature of operating system. So the next is utility software. Utility software is a program that assists in the smooth functioning of a computer. So some of the utility software, it will avoid from the virus attack. Some utility helping to taking the backup data. Some utility software helping to take the recover data which accidentally lost the data from the computer. And some the utility software, it will get in the licensed computer shops. Some are freely available in the internet. So let's understand some utility softwares like antivirus utility. It provides the protection to our computer against the virus attack. So second one is backup. This is a process of recovering the data from sometimes accidentally we will lost the data. The hard disk can fail anytime. So this is a process of recovering the data. Example like CD, flash player. We can store the data in this. So the third one is compression. Compression is the process of shrinking the files. Shrinking the file means we are compressing the files. We will reduce the space of the files by compressing. Example like WinZip, PK file, 7-zip, etc. When you will join to school, that time I'll show you practically how to compress the file and how to extract the file. So now in the next class we will learn about what are the application softwares.